for attending this Eagle Court of Honor this evening for Zach and Noah. Before we begin our program, we'd like to acknowledge the family and friends of each of our new Eagle Scouts. We have the Hennings and we have the Borks. You guys can. We now ask all Eagle Scouts present to please rise and state your name, troop number, where, and when you earned your Eagle. We'll start right here and we'll go back. Thank you. Would our color guards please bring forth the colors to begin this court of honor? Please rise. Would you all please join me in the Pledge of Allegiance? I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you. Color Guard, please post the colors. Color Guard dismissed. Would you all please join us in the Scout Oath? On my honor, I will do my best to do my duty to God and my country, to obey the Scout Law, to help other people at all times, to keep myself physically strong, mentally awake, and morally straight. Thank you. Would you all please join us in the Scout Law? A Scout is trustworthy, loyal, helpful, friendly, courteous, kind, obedient, cheerful, thrifty, brave, clean, and reverent. Thank you. You may now be seated. Good evening, everyone. My name is Alex Guzzi, and I am a Junior Assistant Scoutmaster and Life Scout from Troop 702, and I'm honored to serve as Master of Ceremonies as we honor Scouts Zachary Bork and Noah Hennings for attaining Scouting's highest rank, the Eagle Scout Award. This is a great moment worthy of honor and celebration. At this time, I would now like to ask Ms. Monahan, our troop's Religious Emblems Coordinator, to open the ceremony with a moment of prayer.
Good evening. This prayer was written by a father of two Eagle Scouts in New Jersey. O Lord, grant that I may possess the will and the strength to live up to my solemn obligations, to do my duty to God and my country, to serve my community, to all mankind be trustworthy, friendly, courteous, kind, obedient, cheerful, thrifty, brave, clean, and reverent, to help others at all times, especially those who are weak or in need, to assist my fellow scouts along the Eagle Trail, providing leadership and inspiration that they may also experience the fulfilling rewards of scouting. To keep myself physically strong, mentally awake, and morally straight in every undertaking of my daily life. To respect our wildlife and environment, to be prepared, and to do my best in every endeavor. Never to forget that I am an Eagle. And amen.
Thank you, Ms. Monahan. I now call on Scoutmaster John Myers to officially convene this court of honor.
Good evening, everybody. By the power vested in me by the National Council of Boy Scouts of America and the Spirit of Adventure Council, I now declare this court of honor to be duly convened for the purposes of presenting the highest achievement of the Boy Scouts of America, the Eagle Scout Award, to Zachary Bork and to Noah Hennings, the 109th and 110th Eagle Scouts of this, the 100th year of Troop 702 in Reading, Massachusetts. The Eagle Award is the highest award given to a scout who has attained the ideals and goals of the Boy Scouts of America. The path toward Eagle is both long and challenging. However, these scouts who have worked hard and practiced the principles outlined in the Scout Oath and the Scout Law have received the true benefits of scouting. To receive the Eagle Award requires many tasks, in addition to a minimum time of service and a display of leadership qualities. A scout must earn 21 merit badges, 13 of which are Eagle required, and must serve his community with outstanding service and conservation projects, culminating with the final Eagle service project. All these achievements provide the basis for supplying worthy citizens in our communities from within the scouting ranks. Now I'd like to call up Ben Correa and Charlie Lloyd to go through the stages of scouting.
We're here to honor Eagle Scouts Zachary Bork and Noah Hennings. But this is not the first time they have been recognized before the Court of Honor. Six times before, they have received rank advancements. First, where they received their Scout badge, then when they earned each rank leading to Eagle. And each time, they grew a little taller, became a little wiser, and ever more dedicated to the ideals of scouting. Let's take a moment to reflect back on the steps on the road to Eagle. A new scout wears the fleur-de-lis, the symbol of scouting around the world. The three parts of the fleur-de-lis represent the three parts of the scout oath, which he is beginning to learn and live. A tenderfoot scout badge has an eagle and shield, representing our country, and two stars that represent truth and knowledge. A second-class scout badge is a scroll inscribed with the scout motto, "Be prepared." Suspended from the scroll is a knot that is a reminder to do a good turn every day. A first-class scout badge shows the complete scout emblem, the fleur-de-lis, eagle and shield, and scroll, indicating the completion of basic scout training. A star scout badge symbolizes the unlimited opportunities that lie before the scout, just like the stars in the night sky. A star scout can shine as brightly as any of them. A Life Scout badge, one step from Eagle, is a heart that shows the scouting's lessons have been taken to heart so that the scout is ready to spread its wings and fly.
Thank you. In just a few short years, Zachary and Noah have undergone a transformation from struggling to learn and memorize the Scout Oath and Law to becoming one who lives those words. They have emerged from those who wanted to go camping to those who have camped many times, and from those who needed to be led to those who are fully capable of leading others. We are here to honor these young men as they become Eagle Scouts. As we do so, it is important to reflect on what it means to be an Eagle Scout. The 1938 Handbook for Scoutmasters put it this way: "The badges which accompany his advancement and which are the scout wears on his uniform are not to show that he has passed certain tests. There should be no past tense implied. On the contrary, each badge cries out, 'I can,' right here and right now." So what can the Eagle Scout do? Let's take a look at some of the things he has done in preparing to be an Eagle Scout. In terms of badges, he has earned the Scout badge, the ranks of Tenderfoot, Second Class, First Class, Star, Life, and finally, Eagle. Along the way, he has earned 13 required merit badges and 8 elective merit badges, served in troop leadership positions for a total of 16 months, and spent at least 13 hours on service projects, not including the many hours he spent on his own Eagle project. In all, he has completed approximately 325 requirements. So what have these requirements taught him? Who is the Eagle Scout? First and foremost, of course, he is an outdoorsman. He knows how to camp, swim, hike, use woods tools, build a fire, a camp stove, and find his way with a map and compass. He has spent at least 20 days and nights camping out in a tent that he pitched on a site that he selected. Many of those times, he planned his own menu and cooked his own food. The Eagle Scout is comfortable with nature. He can identify local plants, animals, and poisonous plants. He understands the causes of water, land, and air pollution, and has developed a project to solve an environmental problem. He embodies the Scout motto, "Be prepared." He knows how to treat fractures, head injuries, hypothermia, convulsions, frostbite, burns, abdominal pains, muscle cramps, and even knocked out teeth. He knows what to do in case of a fire, explosion, desert emergency, motor vehicle accident, mountain accident, food poisoning, gas leak, earthquake, flood, tornado, hurricane, and an avalanche. The Eagle Scout is a good citizen. He has been to a town meeting and knows how town government is organized. He knows who his U.S. senators and representatives are and has written a letter to one of them about a national issue. He's read the Declaration of Independence and the U.S. Constitution. He knows how to manage his money and understands the risks and benefits of putting his money in savings bonds, mutual funds, common stock, and real estate. He has set financial goals and worked towards achieving those goals. The Eagle Scout has also set and worked towards fitness goals. He has competed against himself in tests of aerobic endurance, flexibility, and muscular strength. He knows what it means to be physically, mentally, and socially fit. He is a good family member. He knows what things are important to the members of his family and has talked to his family about finances, drug abuse, and growing up. All these things he did in order to earn the merit badges required for Eagle. Beyond those, he has earned 8 elective merit badges, which introduced him to such subjects as aviation, tracking, wilderness survival, snow sports, electricity, fishing, motorboating, photography, disability awareness, and shooting. So what is an Eagle Scout? Well, to quote that old handbook for Scoutmasters again, he is a young man who is qualified to help others as well as take care of himself. His badge is not a decoration, but rather a symbol of knowledge and eligibility. It is now time for the highlight of our program, the presentation of the Eagle Scout Award. I'd like to ask Scoutmaster John Myers to present the Eagle Charge.
Are you ready? Here we go. Becoming an Eagle Scout is a great accomplishment. Being an Eagle Scout is a great responsibility. As an Eagle, the Scout Oath and the Scout Law should take on new meaning for you. The motto and slogan take on new urgency. As an Eagle, your first obligation is to live with honor. You are a marked man, a leader, for good or ill. People will follow the example you set. Give up anything before you give up your reputation and your good name. As Shakespeare said, "Mine honor is my life. Both grow in one. Take honor from me, and my life is done." Let the white of the Eagle badge remind you of honor. Your second obligation as an Eagle Scout is to be loyal. As a follower, you promised to be loyal to those above you. Now as a leader, you must also be loyal to those below you. You must also be loyal to those below you, sorry. Treating them as you would want to be treated. And you must also be loyal to your ideals, not letting others sway you from your course. Let the blue of the Eagle badge remind you of loyalty. Your third obligation as an Eagle Scout is to be courageous. Stepping into your new role as a leader, you will face many challenges and obstacles. A ship in the harbor is safe, but that's not what ships are for. You must have the courage to do what is right, whatever other people do or say. Let the red of the Eagle badge remind you of courage. Your fourth obligation is to serve others, for a leader is above all a servant. Let the practice of a daily good turn become a lifetime of service for all in living, for only in giving of yourself. Do you give anything of value? Let's start that one again. Let the practice of daily good turn become a lifetime of service, for only in giving of yourself do you give anything of value. Just as it's always has, let the scroll of the badge remind you of service. Your final obligation as an Eagle Scout is to have vision. As a leader, you must now blaze your own trail. Just as the bald eagle soaring high above the ground, glad you laughed. Bald eagle soaring high above the ground can look far into the distance, so too must you look far into the future. Many people will follow you. Only with vision will you lead them in the right direction. Let the silver eagle hanging from your badge remind you of vision. These are your obligations as an Eagle Scout: honor, loyalty, courage, service, and vision. By meeting those obligations, you can lead your troop, your community, and your nation towards a better tomorrow. Gentlemen, your parents have been your primary source of help and strength. Let's start with Zach. Mike and Karen, come on up. No one will ever know the unnumbered acts of self-sacrifice your mother has made. In recognition of your mother's devotion, I would like you to please present her with this Eagle Mother's pin. Your father has been a source of much advice and guidance along the Eagle Trail. Please present him with this Eagle tie tack. Mike, in turn, I would like you now to pin the Eagle Scout medal on Zachary's uniform. We have a round of applause for Zach. You ready? Gets easy when we do two in a row. No one will ever know the unnumbered acts of self-sacrifice your mother has made. In recognition of your mother's devotions, I would like you to please present her with this Eagle Mother's pin. Your father has been a source of much advice and guidance along the Eagle Trail. Please present him with this Eagle tie tack. Tom, in turn, I'd like you to pin the Eagle Scout medal onto Noah's uniform. great congratulations to Noah and his family. Before I leave, I have a couple other things here. Eagle Scout awards and letter from the councils for each of Zachary and Noah. Also, there's a card here. It looks like a credit card. You really can't buy anything with it. Hold on to these two. Congratulations. We also have some troop gifts here. We'll see those later. Note the birch bark paper. Okay, you're up.
At this point, I ask Zachary and Noah's mentor, Jerry Hagerty, to come forward.
All right. Hello, everyone. Zach, Noah. I've had the unique pleasure of being the Scoutmaster of Troop 702 the day each of you chose to cross over into Boy Scouts and join us here in Troop 702. I must say, I remember those early days vividly. The monthly campouts, the turkey roasts, the bike trips, the summer camps, the weekly troop meetings, and more weekly troop meetings. The time passed quick, which I assume is a good thing. I heard all about your trips to Seabase, and have to say, it's with a big smile that I'm here today talking. I had the pleasure of being the mentor for both these boys on their Eagle Scout project. And I'll be the first to tell you, I'm really not that good a mentor. These guys had to work twice as hard as all the other Eagle Scouts to get their projects done. And they did a great job, both of them. Each of your projects left a lasting mark on the town of Reading. While everyone will see your bridges and be thankful for everything that they add to the usability of our town's forests, very few know how much preparation and work went on behind the scenes to make these projects successful. You both had to be proactive and prepared in so many ways throughout the whole process that it's hard to communicate just what kind of work went into this in just a few sentences. You know, I was kind of thinking about what to say today, and it's pouring rain, and it just reminded me of all the times we spent camping together in the woods, learning all these lessons that ultimately led to this day. When we were camping in the rain and the snow and everything in between, and trust me, it's everything, we really learned how to prepare not only to survive these challenges, but to thrive. We learned how to embrace these challenges to the point where we kind of look forward to it, and it was a strange dynamic when it occurred. You know, you guys are going to have a lot of fun explaining to others the special feeling that comes from a turkey roast in pouring rain, where to everyone's surprise except your own, you not only stay dry, but you thrive in these various forms of tent cities and hobo villages that you put together. And I'm talking in inches and inches of rain. They would put together top villages where a dozen boys would sleep underneath and just be smiling the whole time. I guess those are some of the times that you're going to remember the best and the most. Noah, I saw a picture of you climbing Cannon during this year's trip to Lonesome Lake, and it reminded me, especially at this time of year, about all the times that we spent winter camping. The December trip, just for those that may not be familiar, in December the troop goes to one of the AMC huts in New Hampshire. It's typically either Lonesome Lake or Carter Dome, Carter Notch, up in Carter Notch. And it's typically a warm-up for the winter's apex trip, the freeze-out. We get our feet wet hiking in the winter, preparing for the cold, and in the evening, we enjoy generous portions of troop-made chili, playing dominoes, or in Zach's case, trying to teach Mr. Hagerty how to play hearts, and still didn't stick. But we're by a warm stove, we're only a mile away from the cars, and it's a great icebreaker for the winter. The real winter camping, though, is a test that is yet to come during the darkest days of winter, when it's time to go on our annual freeze-out. And for those of you who have yet to experience the pleasure of such an experience. I strongly recommend you put this on your bucketing list for scouting. During what we call a freeze-out, we often find ourselves in the middle of the New Hampshire woods in temperatures as low as 15 degrees below Fahrenheit. That's a measured temperature that we were out in. Just us in the middle of the cold forest. Tents won't even help you at those temperatures. There are no wood stoves. No one's playing dominoes. No one's playing hearts. You're just embracing nature in its rawest forms. Honestly, the terms ice age and boreal forest come to mind, and they take on a whole new meaning on these kind of trips. Noah, I remember the freeze out where you, after awakening in the middle of the night to use the facilities, forgot to put on your boots before venturing outside. And not only the amount of time it took for your feet to warm up, but also for your dad's feet to warm up. But what really sticks out in my mind is us hiking back to the cars afterwards. And we passed a hiker on the way in who broke the news that it was minus 15 degrees the night before. And I can't believe you had this crew of young boys in there camping in this kind of weather. Meanwhile, I see him just pass on by after saying this and passing Noah and the boys. And it was either Noah or one of his buddies walking past this hiker who was amazed at these guys and just whistling on his way back to the car, knowing that at the end of this journey, we were going to the diner and going to feast ourselves over in exit 22 in Tilton. But one of the many lessons that we learned was that you'll probably remember for the rest of your life. Growth often comes at the expense of comfort and safety. And grow on that trip, you did. Zach, I remember our time at Hancock as one where the troops spent much of the day building snow caves in temperatures that would freeze a cup of hot chocolate solid if you left it unattended. I'm not sure it hit minus 15, but it was well below zero. Thanks to some great planning and preparation, though, we enjoyed one of the best meals we ever had together. I see Mike shaking his head. Baked Idaho potatoes and open-fire grilled steaks in sub-zero temperatures. And I'm talking, it was so cold, if you got 10 feet outside of the fire, you were freezing. And at the end of this trip, at the end of the night, when the fire's dying and you have to go to your snow cave to sleep, the walk from here to like the door seems like 3 miles. It's just like, oh my God, I can't leave the fire for this. But being prepared had its benefits, and the severity of our trials often magnified the benefits of that experience and the taste of the food. Guys, in both cases, I was struck by how each of you had changed for the better from the experience, how you challenged yourselves to venture beyond your comfort zone and experience a part of life that very few ever really get to experience. You may not have noticed yourselves, but afterwards, I noticed that each of you stood a little taller, spoke a little firmer, flinched less, and morphed into someone that was much more prepared to take on life's challenges. As much as anything else, this is what scouting is all about. And I respect each of you immensely for the way you embraced these experiences and allowed them to work their magic and how they have helped you grow into the men you are today. You are not the same person you were when you first crossed over into scouting several years ago. You're much more. You are much, much more. The Eagle Charge that Mr. Myers read for us earlier reminds us that a ship in the harbor is safe, but that's not what ships are for. And I ask each of you to never forget the lessons that you learned during the adventures on these freeze-outs that we did, or where you left those safe harbors behind, and with proper preparation and planning, stepped outside your comfort zone and embraced life to its fullest. To each of you, as you embark on life's daring adventures and endeavors, I say Godspeed. And thank you for allowing me and everyone in the room to share the time we did with you on your path to becoming an Eagle Scout.
Thank you, Mr. Hegarty. I would now like Zachary to recognize his mentor by presenting Mr. Hegarty with the Scouting Mentor Pin. Great. And I would also like Noah to recognize Mr. Hegarty, his mentor, by also pinning the mentor pin. And now it gives me great pleasure to present to you our newest Eagle Scouts, Zachary Bork and Noah Hennings. Thank you. And each one of them has something to talk about their experiences with scouting up until their earning of the Eagle Scout Merit Badge. So we'll start with Zach, and once he is done, we'll go over to Noah.
First of all, I'd like to thank all of you for taking time out of your day to attend this Court of Honor. It is such an honor for me to receive my Eagle Scout Award. It is one that I would never have received without the help and prodding of many people, and for that I am extremely thankful. I would like to thank my parents for being there for me all along the trail to Eagle from a first year Tiger Cub right through to this moment. Without your help and encouragement, I never would have completed my Eagle. I would also like to thank all the scout leaders that I have had the privilege to meet and work with along the trail. Both scoutmasters Mr. Hegarty to Mr. Myers, who spent countless hours running and planning our meetings and trips. I also want to thank Mr. Sullivan and Mr. Ford, who not only sat on most of my board's review, but along the way gave me guidance that helped me to Eagle and also the trip down the trail of life. I would also like to thank all my fellow scouts, past and present, that helped me become a better scout and a better person. A special thanks goes to my mentor, Mr. Hegarty. He always made scouting a game with a purpose, from always being willing to try something new or to go off the script when the situation arises. And also for showing not just leadership, but friendship along the way. Along the trail to Eagle, I have learned many skills like first aid, how to handle emergency situations, leadership skills, teamwork, mediator skills. Most importantly for me, I learned a lot about being more open, advocating for myself, and actually putting forth my ideas and sharing them. Due to my participation in scouting, I have been able to go to camp at many interesting places like the Battlefield of Gettysburg, where we camped, where the Confederate soldiers camped, and Florida Sea Base, which is a small island in the Florida Keys Reserve just for the scouts. I also got to go to the National Youth Leadership Training, also known as NYLT, 2 years ago over the summer. Over the course of these countless trips and meetings, I have slowly climbed my way to the ranks of Boy Scouts, and having achieved Life Scout and finally Eagle Scout. Eagle Scout is highest ranked. Boy Scouts, only a mere 6% of Scouts achieved it. I had already finished my Eagle Scout project. I built a 26-foot long bridge over an intermittent stream. To do that, I had to run a fundraiser, which I raised around $1,100. I am happy to have joined the 6% of Scouts that have earned the rank of Eagle.
Activity in my life growing up. Starting as a Cub Scout, I knew how important the outdoors was to me. One of my favorite memories in Scouts was during the Florida Sea Base trip, when we had to get our food for the week off of a dock about a quarter mile from the shore. Our island mate, Evan, told us just to go get it, and that's all. So we decided to take a canoe and wade it out to the dock and then load up the four or so trash cans full of food which was difficult since I could hardly touch the ground whenever a wave would pass by. It was sketchy since the canoe felt like it was going to tip over at any point, but we made it. Scouting has been a great adventure, and I'm glad to continue as an adult leader and through Venture Scouts. Achieving my Eagle Scout rank was something that I could not have done without my mom, my dad, Mr. Hegarty, Mr. Myers, Mr. Bork, Mr. Sullivan, Mr. Ford, Mr. Connery, Mr. Guzzi, and all the other adult leaders who have had an influence on me. My two older brothers, Jacob and Zach, along with Jacob's friends in the troop, and my own friends out in and out of Boy Scouts, have also been good influences on me.
Thank you, Noah and Zach. Zachary and Noah, you deserve much credit for having achieved Scouting's highest award. But wear your award with humility, ever mindful the Eagle Scout is looked up to as an example. May the Scout Oath and the Scout Law be your guide for tomorrow and onwards. I now call the Color Guard to please retire their colors. Please stand. Thanks, Chris. Color Guard to your post. Please retire the colors. This evening has indeed been a very special evening. Thank you all for coming out and participating in this wonderful event. Please join us following this ceremony for a reception and honoree of Zachary and Noah. I now declare this Eagle Court of Honor closed. Please join us downstairs. And thank you again to Zachary and Noah. Congratulations. I was going to go to the